I'm a drug addict to it. I'm chemically dependent on it. And so is every farmer in the world, basically. It's such an effective herbicide that chemical companies have really made us use it.
Every regulator around the world has looked at this substance over the last 40 years and found that particularly if used in the way that we use it, it is safe.
There's still people out there who think smoking doesn't cause cancer. There's enough evidence that we should be very cautious about this product in industrial use.
The evidence for not only potential carcinogenicity, but also metabolic illness is very compelling, and that therefore we should be exercising great caution in how we use this pesticide.
We get up every morning, go and do some work on the farm. Every single day.
It's not a drudge. You can be down the back and next minute there's half a day gone, and you know, a little bit later there's a full day gone, but you've done a fair bit of work in that day. It's just farming. It's just a way of life.
Ron and Tradley have an idyllic life on the New South Wales south coast.
Iconic is really overdone, but Tilba is really the iconic spot. 50 years this year we've been on the farm. The farm's 350 acres. We've had beef cattle. We've had sheep in the past. We've got Christmas trees now.
Before we realised that I had the cancer, it was just ordinary living.
In 2010, Trey Lee was diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma and told she had 6 months to live.
When you're told that you've got potentially a death sentence, your life changes. You find out what's really important in life, and it's all your kids, your family, your husband, everything.
It's just like life with a hand grenade with a pin pulled out. That's just really what it's like. It's you're just on the edge.
But it was what the oncologist said to them that really hit home.
He said, "You've got farmer's lymphoma." And then he asked us after that, he said, "What do you do?" And we said, "Farmers." And these are the words that you don't forget. And he said, "Too many farmers are being represented in this particular sort of cancer for it to be a coincidence." He said, "It's something that you blokes are doing on the farm that's actually causing lymphoma." I just racked my mind and I just come straight back to the chemicals that we were using.
The chemical Ron's talking about is glyphosate, the active ingredient in the weedkiller Roundup. It's one of the most widely used herbicides, and countless scientific studies have proven its safety. A 2016 study showed over 8.5 billion kilograms of the stuff has been sprayed on fields around the world. But in 2015, the World Health Organization classified glyphosate as probably carcinogenic. The manufacturer Monsanto strongly rejects that listing.
When you have the World Health Organization putting out warnings that this is more than likely a carcinogen, it's you know, I'm disgusted that a company can put money above morality.
The debate over Roundup safety came to a head in a US court case last month when Monsanto was ordered to pay almost $400 million to a groundskeeper after a jury found his long-term use of the product caused his terminal cancer.
This morning, fallout from a monumental verdict.
This case was historic.
He claims their weed killer Roundup made him sick.
The size of the punitive damages award reflected the jury's belief that the company, Monsanto, had acted with malice.
This court case in the US is the first of 5,000 currently pending in the US.
Environmental groups like Greenpeace are also taking up the fight to halt sales of Roundup.
It's literally designed to kill things. And until we know a lot more about the effects of Roundup on the human body, we think that it should be pulled out of shops and that there should be restrictions placed on its use.
It's a call some of the world's leading researchers agree with. Dr. Michael Antonio is a molecular toxicologist at King's College in London. He's studied the safety of the product for years and found regular use of glyphosate in even smaller amounts than what's recommended by regulators caused significant health issues, including cancer.
For the last 4 years, we have been conducting research on the toxicity of glyphosate-based herbicides that in rats that were consuming Roundup that was many, many thousands of times lower than what regulators say is safe to consume on a daily basis. The rats in our study still came down with serious metabolic problems. It's very, very clear, even from industry studies, that glyphosate does cause cancer at the doses at which it was tested. And this came out very clearly in the evidence presented in the court case in San Francisco.
That court case has left Monsanto in damage control. It rejects the ruling and is appealing the payout.
The jury's decision does not change the fact that more than 800 scientific studies and reviews and regulatory authorities around the world, including Australia, support the fact that glyphosate does not cause cancer.
But despite the denial, some in Australia are urging caution. Sanchia Aranda runs the Cancer Council.
The International Agency for Research on Cancer don't make these rulings lightly. They have classed it as a probable carcinogen, which is the sort of second level of importance, and will be taking a watching brief and keeping an eye on that evidence.
The Cancer Council has stopped short from calling for a ban, but it's concerned about the developments.
There was a suggestion that Monsanto has information that it is kept from the public. And Cancer Council's position on that would be that there is zero tolerance for any industry that withholds health and safety information from the public about any of their products. We saw that happen with the tobacco industry.
But not all farmers are worried.
We've been using it on our farm for about the last 30 years. We actually use way less of it on our farm now than we did 30 years ago because we have the newer techniques where we actually just put a spot of glyphosate on each individual weed rather than spraying it out across the whole fallow paddock.
Fiona Simpson knows the harsh reality of being out on the land. She's a farmer and president of the National Farmers Federation.
This substance has been extensively studied. The reputable science, the regulator science, every regulator around the world has looked at this substance over the last 40 years and found that particularly if used in the way that we use it, it is safe.
But Ron reckons the recommended safety precautions aren't in tune with the reality of farming.
It's safe practice should be geared to me, not in what someone says in a lab you should do. Let them see what safe practice is and then adapt their chemicals to what we do.
Trey Lee is now in remission, but after decades of using the product, the couple's worried their ordeal isn't over.
Every day, you lay in bed and you feel every heartbeat she's got, and every time she rolls that you don't sleep. That's just one of those feelings of absolute guilt. But the thing that negates it with me is that I should have been informed. I should have, you know, if some bastard knew that this was going to happen or that their chemical could have done this, and the evidence is coming out now, they're the ones that have to be held to account.
I worry he's going to get cancer. Yeah, it's there all the time.
Well, it doesn't matter to me now because my wife's got it. That's just how it is.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I think I should have cancer because she got it because it's something I did.
No.
I think that I should suffer as well.
No. Why should you think that?
It's just how it is.
No.
The government body which decides whether or not products like Roundup are safe for sale is the Australian Pesticides and Veterinary Medicines Authority, or the APVMA. Despite the US court decision, it hasn't reconsidered its approval. It says,
glyphosate is registered for use in Australia, and APVMA-approved products containing glyphosate can continue to be used safely according to label directions.
The APVMA has rigorous processes, and it certainly does not only its own work, but it looks at the work that's been done right across the world.
The Australian Regulatory Agency, they need to really rethink their entire principles, the principles upon which they're evaluating the pesticides and other chemical pollutants, because at the moment, they're completely out of step with the science. So not only should they be taking the latest evidence for glyphosate-based herbicides more seriously, but they should be looking across the board at all classes of pesticides as well as other herbicides.
Is it going to be that in the future that a few farmers are going to die every year and get lymphoma and we're just going to be called collateral damage? I don't want to be collateral damage. I don't want my wife to be collateral damage.